And now, it's time for another Dice Tower Review with Tom Vasel.
Hey folks, I'm Tom Vasel, and today we're taking a look at an expansion for Marvel Legendary, Legendary Shield, which is about S.H.I.E.L.D. and Hydra. It's actually interesting to me that it took a while for them to put this one out, considering how popular this is, not just in the comics. I mean, there's a lot of the major storylines have to do with S.H.I.E.L.D. and Hydra, but also in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, Captain America 2, Winter Soldier, all about Hydra and S.H.I.E.L.D. And so kind of expect this. You have Agent Phil Coulson, and you have a bunch of people in here. Like, if you're not a big fan of the comics, these are probably definitely characters that you don't know. But this introduces that whole dynamic to the game. Let's take a look. So the first thing, and in my opinion, the coolest thing that this expansion happens to add, is more S.H.I.E.L.D. officers. What you do is you're going to shuffle these with Marie Hill, who's the original S.H.I.E.L.D. officer, who you can pay for three and get two. And so you have a bunch of them. There's two copies of each of these different S.H.I.E.L.D. officers, and they also cost three and usually provide two, but they do other things here. But one of the things that they do, and you'll see this here, it says you may send this hero undercover if you want. If you do, you get an extra buy. So when you send somebody undercover, you're basically putting them in your victory pile where they're worth a victory point at the end of the game. But even more importantly, when you stick them in your victory point pile, they increase your S.H.I.E.L.D. level. And that's going to matter as the game goes by. And I'll talk about that in a bit. You'll also notice they all have S.H.I.E.L.D. symbols, but they also are colored. Marie Hill is not colored. So here, like for example, if I have two S.H.I.E.L.D., I can send this one undercover or put it on the top of my deck. Dum Dum Dugan, who's one of my favorite characters, even if I don't know how to, you know, I don't know why his name is Dum Dum, and he can just go undercover, but he's two and an attack. So you shuffle these all, and when you buy a S.H.I.E.L.D. agent, you buy the top one from the deck, so you're hoping to get one of these really cool ones, and they're just neat to see, you know. This one here is the only one that's not just straight up two, but it could be. You can choose to get two or get one and draw a card. And then Melinda May here simply lets you draw a card if you have three other S.H.I.E.L.D. symbols. Now, I told you there was a S.H.I.E.L.D. level in the game now that you play with, where if you put these cards undercover in your victory point pile somehow, or even if Hydra agents show up in your victory point pile, that counts as your S.H.I.E.L.D. level. But you also have a Hydra level, which is the opposite. The Hydra level is if there are S.H.I.E.L.D. agents or Hydra in a Hydra pile. And so, for example, each player must reveal as many hero colors as the Hydra level or gain a wound. And then when these guys escape, they'll go and increase the Hydra level. So here we have the, what's this? These are the AIM Hydra Offshoot, which is kind of a weird, long title for this. And you have some of the people that you probably have never heard of. Crossbones you have, since he was in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And the very... interestingly named Growing Man. But again, you'll notice that all these refer to the Hydra level. And then you have here is one of the masterminds. And this is actually one of the coolest parts of the game is, so this mastermind here, who is the Hydra Super Adaptoid, doesn't have a normal card. He has four cards. And so you can see here Black Widow's bike, Captain America's shield, Iron Man's armor, and Thor's hammer. And you're just going to shuffle these cards, and whichever one's at the top is the one that you deal with. And anytime it uses the word adapt, you'll shuffle them again. So you can see if you're going up against Thor's hammer, he's an attack of 14. Here is an attack of 12. And when the master strikes come up, different things will happen, and just various things will happen and cause this guy to adapt. Very similarly, there is the Hydra High Council. They work the same way. So here you have different people. We got Red Skull and Arnim Zola and Viper and then Baron Zemo. And each of these, again, they can adapt and you'll be fighting a specific one at any point in time. And so, for example, here, this guy is 16, but he gets minus one for each villain in the person's victory pile. This guy's 9, Viper, but it's plus one for each Hydra villain in the city. So I really like these masterminds a lot. I like how that they... you're fighting something different all the time. It's like a group, and I hope to see more of these because there are groups of villains, and this is a nice way to do groups. Everything in this set is Hydra and S.H.I.E.L.D., and so including are the schemes. Here is Hail Hydra, which I had to like do a double take because I thought this was already in the game, but it's not. And I do like in this one, when a twist comes up, you say, I'll never abandon S.H.I.E.L.D., and then you can't fight. Or you say, Hail Hydra. You whisper it, and you can't recruit. And a villain captures a bystander, so it depends what comes up. It's a very straightforward one. And then we got the Hydra Helicarriers hunting heroes, Secret Empire of Betrayal. This is a really cool one. I enjoy this, where you'll pick another hero who you can kind of recruit, probably Captain America. And then we have the S.H.I.E.L.D. versus Hydra War. All right, so now let's talk about the good guys in here. We have Agent Phil Coulson. So here he is, holding his own with everybody else. You'll notice that there are cards that say S.H.I.E.L.D. level 3. I mentioned this already. So you simply have to have your S.H.I.E.L.D. level to that point. So if you have this card, it's 2 attack. But once your S.H.I.E.L.D. level is 3, when you draw a new hand of cards at the end of this turn, you draw an extra card. So that's cool. And then you can also send him undercover and things like that. Or he can send other cards undercover. A good thing about undercover is you can send your original cards undercover and also cull your deck. And then this card, which is kind of useless, you know, it helps you color your deck for 6. That's pretty expensive, but then it's +1 for each 2 S.H.I.E.L.D. levels you have. So as time goes by, these cards get more powerful. And then his big nasty card here, during any player's turn, when a S.H.I.E.L.D. hero is put in the KO pile, you may discard this to send that hero undercover in your victory pile. So if you get someone knocked out, and then if you do, you draw 3 cards. And once your S.H.I.E.L.D. level is 8, this is not a 4 attack, rather it is an 8 attack. Now that's a bit of a setup here, I think, a kind of card to play, but it is cool. Mockingbird is also in here. So she has the opportunity to send people undercover if they're shields. Draw a card if S.H.I.E.L.D. level is 2, otherwise still for straight up 2 attack. Here she can send people undercover, get +1 attack for every 2 S.H.I.E.L.D. levels you have. You're seeing a theme here, and if there's one negative thing I'll say about this set is I don't feel like these heroes are that indistinguishable from each other. You know, I don't, like Mockingbird and Agent Phil Coulson, they kind of do very similar things. Although I do like this one as +1 and 1 for every 2 S.H.I.E.L.D. levels you have. So Quake here, again, this is a 2 attack, but S.H.I.E.L.D. level 2, it's 4 attack. Pretty good for only 4 cost. And then to play this one, you need to discard a hero, but you can send that hero undercover if you played another blue card, and then it's 3. And then Tectonic Wave, Roll the Earth. I really like this card a lot, where you can send a hero from the S.H.I.E.L.D. officer undercover. Then for each S.H.I.E.L.D. level you have up to 5, choose a hero from the headquarters. Put all those heroes in the bottom of the deck and get their attack. This is one of those cards, I don't know, these are the kind of cards I really enjoy, where you, if you're lucky and there's a bunch of high attack cards out on the table, you can do this massive, awesome attack that Quake can do. Deathlok, also again, working with S.H.I.E.L.D. levels, sending people undercover. And here his big one is you can send a hero undercover, and then you get the total money value of all S.H.I.E.L.D. heroes in your victory point pile, which could really add up after a while. So I like his card a lot too. He and Quake are my 2 favorites from this set. And there you have it. Very simple expansion in a sense that it, you know, it adds what it adds. It's a S.H.I.E.L.D. Hydra. Now, this is one of the expansions that when you get it, it's not one I necessarily recommend easily mixing in with everything else. This one works really well together. And you'll enjoy the S.H.I.E.L.D. level / Hydra level stuff more if you play with these agents against one of these villains with their subgroups and stuff. It's definitely built that way. Now you can mix this stuff in, and for example, the S.H.I.E.L.D. officer pile, I'm using that in every game. That's fantastic. I love that addition to the game. It just makes that pile a little bit, I mean, you're still gonna get, it's not like you're gonna get anything worse than Marie Hill, and you might get something better. So that's just a fun, entertaining thing to add to the game. And I like the heroes, but like I said, it is a little weird to me that the 4 of them are somewhat indistinguishable. Like if you read a card and said, is that Mockingbird, Phil Coulson, Quake? I'd be like, I don't know. You know, because they're all very similar in how they work. And that's another thing where I said this kind of works together. You could argue that that's thematic because they're all agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and therefore they have to follow the same rules and stuff. I really like the villains. I love to see more villain groups like this in the future. Depending on how popular this set is, I wouldn't be surprised if we see more of that. But anyway, that's what's in this expansion, Legendary S.H.I.E.L.D. I'm Tom Vasel, and you've been watching the Dice Tower. Dice Tower Judgment approved.